Adopt a dog. I did. Our shepherd lab mix, Freedom, is the happiest guy in the world. So with the blue dog Democrats looking for a home, ears down, tail between the legs, after being abandoned by the Obama administration, should the Republicans adopt a dog or keep them crated? Let's ask radio host and Gannett columnist Mike Papantonio. Hey, Paps, what about it? You got some blue, you have blue dog Democrats looking a little homeless right now, trying to figure out if Obama's going to save them or not. What do you recommend? Should they move further right and join the GOP?
I wouldn't adopt them. I tell you, lay down with dogs, you get fleas. That's the lesson of Blue Dog Democrat. Here's what you have to understand about the Blue Dog Democrat. They tell everybody that they're tigers, but really they're trained monkeys for corporate America. If you take a close look at what Blue Dog Democrats have done their entire career, go back and take a look. You tell me how many times they've created a bill that's actually done anything for the American public. It's usually about them trying to put more money in their coffers. And look, go back and take a look at where the money comes from. Take a look at how the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, UBS, Citigroup, Bank of America put more money in the coffers of Blue Dog Democrats than Republicans to some degree. Now, here's the real point.
You know, Mike, the problem is, though, I'm going to stick with this adopt a dog theme. You know,
wait, Lobo who's was, the dog? The blue Lobo? Dogs? Okay, we're talking about the
Lobo was left in the shelter for 4 months. Nobody wanted him. Partly because even the people in the shelter were sort of sick of Lobo. Too much energy, wasn't routing right. Is this an actual precursor of the Democrat Party and Republican Party starting to crack apart? We're going to see some fissures.
You know what, Cody, is the best thing that can happen. It's just like you guys talk about market corrections all the time. This is a political correction. To me, as a progressive, I would rather see the Democratic control of Congress die and let the American public understand that we're not going to allow Blue Dog Democrats to come back in through the back door, disguising themselves as Democrats when they're really just Republicans. Look, they're more dangerous than Republicans. They're more dangerous than dull-witted
Republicans.
No, no,
Mike,
wait.
Here's the problem. The problem, though, Mike, before you go into the here's why. The problem is that Americans want things accomplished. You know, housing's still a mess. Unemployment's still a mess. Businesses are unsure. They keep on telling us about what the heck is going to go on. So you have, it's not only the Blue Dog Democrats. It's also the Liberal Democrats and the Republicans. Nothing's going to get accomplished because, you know what? They all care only about their own selfishness, political agenda, than the well-being of the American public.
Well, I'm all in on that one, but I have to tell you this. Obama, the last thing he needs to do is try to cater to these Blue Dog Democrats. He needs to go back to his basic game plan. That's to talk about change and deliver change rather than just talking about it. Look, do you think for a second that we're going to be any better off as a progressive movement by saying to these Blue Dog Democrats, get out of the party. You're not part of the party. At least with the Republicans, you know where they're coming from. They stand for something, even though they don't understand. Understand what it is, they don't understand why. Somebody can tell them to stand for something, and they do.
But here's the issue. I that was a good story about 2 weeks ago, Tuesday. As of that Massachusetts Senate election, the story changed. I think it was a wake-up call. The Blue Dogs in Denver, and even your far-left progressive party, America doesn't want far-left liberal ideas anymore. They want something down the middle, if not all the way to the right.
These guys would be best served
jumping over the GOP or losing those seats, which they likely will to GOP in November.
I hope they jump to the GOP, and then we have another 8 years of dark GOP years where we go through the same kind of misery we went through with 8 years, with an economy crashing, two wars we shouldn't be in. And then everybody says, we don't want you back in our party.
Mike, I got to ask you. I see two wars going on. I see an economy. Okay, they measured it this month. It was up 5.7% last quarter. But Mike, I mean, come on. It's a continuation of the same policies. You're going to sit here and pretend that somehow it's different again?
No, it's not different again, but what you have to say is this, Cody. You can't, to me as a progressive, I could care less about these corporate shills called Blue Dog Democrats who have never done anything creative besides trying to figure out how they're going to get reelected. Again, give me a Republican, at least I know.
Republican Democrat regime?
All right, Mike, we got to end it there. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
well, we have you back all the time. You get your points
in. We love that 70s set.
What does it say? I'm Mike Papantonio, and you're not. Thanks a lot.